We're back again, and we're talking about the NFC East today. One of the many topics of the first quarter of the NFL football season. So far, we have not fared too well as Redskins fans. Reason for that being, we have an incompetent coach. And I'm saying that right now because it almost is just like I'm repeating myself. We've said this before on this very show, that we just have a coach who's not ready to do what he's been asked to do. He's being paid to do it. That's his job. Hadn't done it.
He's stealing money.
So he's not qualified.
Not qualified. And that goes further into ownership, okay? The owner wants to handpick someone who he can not get a lot of resistance from. But out of not resistance, you're getting no results. Not good ones anyway.
But I don't think he is doing that now, especially with McLaurin. McLaurin is not like that with that general manager. That GM. I just think now he hired Gruden before McLaurin came into the picture.
Correct.
We saw what happened last year.
Yep.
With that record.
Yep.
Now I'm thinking I think Snyder has stepped back from his organization. All he is gonna write the check.
Well, you know what? I'd like to believe that.
Okay.
Because if that's the case, we can get a competent coach here. Because right now, we don't have it. There may be some competent coaches on the staff somewhere.
Doug Williams for head coach.
Right now, you know.
Right here on Spencer's mouth, Doug Williams for coach.
It's at a point where it's personal for me. I sacrifice my Sundays. I give my tithes and I watch football. And it's just not happening, man. I'm not going
to
spend time on my knees.
You give your tithes to Snyder?
Well, you might as well say so. This represents his name, doesn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah.
So
my
thing,
too?
Pretty much.
Yeah.
Tithes and offers. Maybe if we take a collective pool, we can get something done. But at this point right now, it's just a sad season that's playing itself out slowly, kind of dying a slow death.
I don't think your man understands strengths and weaknesses of your team. I don't think he plays to your team's strength. He wants to build something, but he's not taking advantage of the talent level that you got, so each other's intertwining and covering up for each other's weaknesses.
I read in the paper yesterday that Washington is the second most injured team in the NFL. Can we say that if that team was healthy, you think we have the same results we have now at 2-4?
Well, yeah. Worms have machine guns, birds will go hungry.
Conditioning coach.
I think
is everybody hurt?
It's a dark cloud that sits above Washington. I hate to say it. It's a dark cloud that sits above Washington. You heard it here. Every time they get on a roll, something happens.
They ain't been on a roll.
We've been on a roll. It's just been the wrong way.
To this point, I will say this. The Skins haven't played bad football. They haven't played absolutely terrible football.
They haven't been playing good enough to win.
But they haven't been playing terrible football. They've been playing very competitive football.
You can't play for 30 minutes. You got to play for 60.
Yeah, that's all
you can't eliminate the third quarter that you're not making changes or the team is not responding to the changes you're making. Maybe it's just that the team's IQ is so low they don't understand what the coach is asking them to do collectively, 53 people. I can't buy that. So I'm saying that the coach needs to change his method and his message.
So is it the coach or is it the quarterback, or could it be both?
Both.
Well, we
obviously they're tied together.
For some reason, I think that it might be just Gruden. I still think Kurt is a decent quarterback in this league to win.
I'm gonna sing you a long, pretty song about that, man. You're killing me with the Kirk. Look, Kirk Cousins is who we thought he was. I'm doing the Denny Green. He is who we thought he was. He's an interception machine. He's a turnover prone. Well, you can't compare them to.
So is Romo.
What has he done?
That's a whole nother conversation.
What has he done?
Look, that's a whole nother segment.
Jeez.
The proven fact of the preseason is this. Regardless of, even after the RG3 injury, if you go based on the body of work during the preseason, Colt McCoy was supposed to be your starter.
Doug Williams for head coach. You heard it first right here on Sports Mouth.
I went to the Lions in the Redskins game during the preseason.
When RG got beat up.
When RG took his last snap and they carried him off the field, they instituted Colt McCoy. Uh-huh. Automatically, instantly, touchdown. Uh-huh. Right down the field.
Colt McCoy's nickname is Gregory Hines. This man every chance he get. Every time he touch the ball, he get happy feet.
Hey, can anybody remember?
G3 Everlast?
Can anybody remember?
Has won a division.
Can anybody remember?
Anyway, go ahead.
Can anybody remember Patrick Ramsey?
Yes.
And how shook up and scared he was. And
Jason Campbell.
Okay. Right. And here's my point. Medical quarterbacking in this league will not get it done. You can't play safe. You can't play soft. This is the NFL. If you get hurt, so be it. That's what you get paid to do. You get paid to take those risks. And I'm telling you right now, they're not taking risks. They're trying to play safe, conservatively, to save their jobs. And you know what they're saving? My money, because I ain't giving them a doggone dime.
So bottom line. Washington goes where and ends where in NFC East. Last.
If they don't get it together and
I think you're still in a toss. Because there's a couple of teams that still haven't found their identity yet.
Let me say this.
In your whole division, there's nobody that's stepped up that's found a real identity yet.
We found our identity. It's just we a punk. We found our identity. We a punk.
If you look at your whole NFC East division, their whole division is taking a beating. A lot of their key players are out.
But that happens every year. This is the mauling dog division right here.
It's got to be.
But that's
got to be.
The weak division.
I would have said Eagles.
Yeah, it's the Giants.
Listen,
right now.
Let me say this. As far as this division goes, we have an opportunity to do some good things here. I don't think anybody can disagree with that.
No,
but we have a coach and a quarterback right now who's so stuck together really. with this. They're mired in mediocrity. Let me say that. All right. You cannot sit here and tell me that everybody else can make adjustments. Every other coach in this league, even the bad ones, can make adjustments at halftime to bring the team out to play some decent football. At least change the message. How you going? What do you do at halftime? Sell lemonade? Mm-hmm. Eat popcorn? Watch a movie?
The message.
I mean, you got to do something that's changing what's going on that field. You see the mistakes.
Yeah.
This is the situation right here. Jay Gruden's doing nothing at the halftime. He's doing nothing at the half. He's doing nothing, period, as it pertains to changing his system. He cannot change his system because he don't know how to change his
then
system.
Then we need to change the coach.
I'm starting to think it ain't even his system.
Wow.
It might be his brother's system.
You know,
he can't touch it because he don't know what to do and how to do it.
So you
check this out, he don't know what the input
You think he called his brother at halftime and said, man, what should I do? You know football a little bit better than I do.
You know what? You might. Family cookouts.
You might.
He slide in the playbook and then go from there.
Hey, look, I hope we get a chance to explore that because that was funny. I'm telling you, and it may be true.
It might be.
Because nobody has confidence that this is the guy that you can go forward with. In two seasons, somebody came up. Did somebody mention his record in two games?
Let me put it up.
And I mean, it's just kind of ridiculous.
In two seasons, he is actually 6-22.
And this is the coach.
And this is Jay Gruden.
With various quarterbacks.
And let me say just to add to that. Let me say this.
In 2009,
he was the offensive coordinator of the Florida Tuskers.
Who the heck is that?
In 2009, he was the head coach of the Florida Tuskers. Now, that says a lot.
He's a team killer.
About his credentials, though. See, what kind of credentials are you hiring?
Did they go off for what he did at Cincinnati?
Well, look. What did he do at Cincinnati?
Absolutely nothing.
No. Okay. I think Patrice has said it right.
His name.
His name is getting him carried. I'm tired of it. That's like Samsonite to me, bro. You don't carry that kind of luggage around. Mm-hmm. If you're gonna come in this league and take this town, and look, I'm going to call it like I really see it. And you two, Sports Mouth fans, I said it before, I'll say it again. I think there's a racial element involved here. You bench the obvious player that can actually operate on the field.
Not your system, because nobody really has confidence in your system. Your system brings no running. Your system brings limited passing. Your system brings limitations all over the field.
Change gonna come. Change is coming. Let them lose
Sam
the tap
Cook,
tomorrow.
Big, Sam Cook.
Let them lose the tap
Sam
tomorrow.
Cook.
Well, okay.
Let them lose the tap tomorrow.
That doesn't take
change is gonna come. When they play New England, what's the offensive coordinator, Bill Callahan?
Oh,
he might be the daggone head coach by the time New England
Bill Callahan can go too.
Yeah, what?
Crazy.
And Joe Barry, you're the first right here on Sports Mouth. Joe Barry can go too.
So the defense is like that, house? Man.
How's the defense?
Oh, my God, defense in the top 10.
You got to understand the one thing about the defense. You're not. If you got an offense that's incompetent, your defense is going to take a beat.
Okay, so the defense is not like that. Let's put.
Well, if you keep setting them up on a short field and they got to defend the short field,
you're going to get gassed.
So they get exposed.
Yeah, they get exposed. Okay. No. So I'm not saying they get exposed. I'm saying they'll be unfairly put upon because the offense is not really doing what they're doing.
Okay. Let's go. Because that team right now, love them to death, but they get on my damn, I'm sorry. So what about the Giants? Where'd he come from all of a sudden?
Oh, Eli.
Oh, you mean the fact that they have good coaching and competent people running their thing?
Where did Eli come from all of a sudden?
Yeah, well.
He went back because he went to sleep against
himself.
Imagine
that. 50-50.
He went back to sleep against
himself. Listen, hold on.
I'll tell you this.
I'm not an Eli fan.
Eli's done.
I'm not an Eli fan, but if you ask me, he's better than Kirk Cousins?
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
I mean, he got some
quarterback. I'll give you the NFC East right now. He's the best quarterback in the NFC East right now.
That's Sam Bradford.
Agreed.
Sam Bradford stinks.
Overrated.
Bradford stinks.
I don't know. He's better than Kirk Cousins.
Sam Bradford don't get no credit.
He beat Joe Lewis behind.
Here's what I'm going to say.
He's throwing multiple interceptions per game. He's doing all right.
Listen, y'all. We're getting ready to come back to y'all. We'll keep this discussion going. You're watching Sports Mouth on YouTube.com.
Good news for head coach.